In this question, it is asking the terminal velocity of a small sphere of radius a in a viscous liquid is proportional to. However, we already studied the direct formula of terminal velocity. You can use that formula to judge at what power of radius terminal velocity is proportional, or we can also visualize and we can derive the relation as well. If we are given with a ball of radius r, and due to the weight mg, it is falling down in a viscous medium. If there's a viscous medium in which it is falling down, so upward it will experience a buoyant force, which is given as mg times rho of liquid by rho of solid. And if it is coming down with the speed v, then it will experience a viscous force upward. And we can write upward viscous force on ball is given by Stokes' rule, as the viscous force we write as 6 pi eta rv, and at terminal speed all forces on a sphere are balanced. So we have, in this situation, we can directly write downward force is mg, which is equals to mg rho l by rho s, plus the viscous force is 6 pi eta rv. Now in this situation, mass can be rewritten as density of solid into 4 by 3 pi r cube multiplied by g, 1 minus density of liquid by density of solid is equals to 6 pi eta rv. So here, rearranging terms, thus giving us the terminal velocity is equals to this 2 by 9 gr square by eta density of solid minus density of liquid. This formula we already derived in theory, and if you just have a look on this, it is giving us that the velocity, terminal velocity, is directly proportional to square of radius, and here the radius is a, so it is matching with option a. So answer to this question here is option a. So the terminal velocity of the sphere will be proportional to a square.